make sure you stay to the end to hear my thoughts on whether or not I would ever get this testing personally. And I want to hear your thoughts about whether you would as well. All right, let's hop in. Careblazer, will there be a blood test for Alzheimer's disease in the very near future? The answer is most likely yes. It will probably be here sooner than we think. In fact, it's already here. So let's talk about why do we care about this? How might we use this? And what could this mean for people like you and me who are wondering about their dementia risk for the future? So right now, the process of getting an official dementia diagnosis is kind of a confusing, long process. Typically, neuropsychological testing has to be done, which it's hard to find a neuropsychologist who specializes in dementia. You'll likely have to wait months. And if you're living in a smaller, more rural area, you might not have access to a specialist close by your town at all. And if you're somebody who's younger or doesn't fit the typical picture of dementia, your doctor might not even want to refer you for specialized testing. So needless to say, the current way that we go about getting a dementia diagnosis is hard, long, confusing for all of us. And when the person with suspected dementia or who's trying to figure out what's going on actually gets in front of a neuropsychologist for testing, that's hours of testing, of paper and pencil testing. So the person has to actually be willing to go through the tests. And not only that, even after they get the score, it's not a matter of this equals dementia or this doesn't. We have to take into account, how do they sleep the night before? Did they eat well before they showed up for the appointment? Was there a lot of distractions in the testing environment? Do they have depression, anxiety, or other issues that might have impacted the score? So it's a really subjective process of coming up with the dementia diagnosis. But neuropsych testing is the gold standard. It's the best that we have right now that we're using in clinical practice. And all of this can change by using blood-based biomarkers. So according to the National Institute on Health, a biomarker stands for biological marker. It's basically a sign that we can observe outside of the patient to tell us what's going on, and that we could reproduce that sign over and over again. Now, biological markers are well established and in practice all over the medical field right now. For instance, if somebody ever tested their blood sugar, their blood glucose, well, that's a biological marker. Somebody is using the blood inside of them to get a number outside of them to figure out what's going on inside. The same thing if you ever gave your blood and got a cholesterol reading level, well, that's the case where somebody took their blood, they're looking at the cholesterol level, the number outside, to see what's going on inside of the body. It's not only with blood. A biological marker could be with other things like tissues. If somebody had a suspicious marking on their body, it could be biopsied and sent away to figure out, are any cancerous cells in here? So biological markers have been going on for a while. Right now, in the field of Alzheimer's disease, we use two types of biological markers. One is called the PET scan, and the other is cerebral spinal fluid. Those are two biological markers that we rely on sometimes to determine whether or not somebody has Alzheimer's disease. But there's two big downfalls on this. Number one, they're extremely costly. And number two, they're quite invasive. So they're not used very often. That's why the idea of a blood-based biomarker is really exciting. When we think about giving blood, it's a much lower cost and it's much less invasive than what we currently have available. What could BBB do for Alzheimer's disease? Number one, it could help with early detection. So how many of you, especially, or you may have heard stories where somebody is younger and so nobody's really thinking about Alzheimer's disease, even though it can happen at an earlier age, or somebody doesn't fit quite the clinical picture of looking like a confused older adult. So maybe the primary care provider doesn't think anything's going wrong and they think, oh, they look fine during this 15-minute appointment, nothing's wrong. And so they don't even refer out for more testing. But a blood test, what it's going to do is it's going to look for certain markers that would suggest Alzheimer's disease. And so by having this blood test, it can make it easier for people to catch the disease earlier. Not only that, the earlier you catch the disease process, the better chance you have at using a lot of the treatments and interventions and having them have a positive impact. We know that by the time Alzheimer's disease shows clinical symptoms, meaning it's obvious to other people around that something is wrong, the actual changes in the brain have been going on for 10, 15, 20 years. So the idea that a blood test could catch this decades sooner is really exciting for the ability to maybe get treatment and intervention much earlier. Number two, I've already mentioned it's way less invasive than trying to get somebody's cerebral spinal fluid and maybe even sending them for hours and hours of neuropsych testing. Number three, it's cost effective. A blood test is much cheaper than the other biological marker testing that we have and much cheaper than neuropsych testing. Number four, it's objective. You take a blood sample, you read the number, you read what's happening in the blood, and it tells you objectively what's going on. Like I mentioned earlier, in neuropsych testing, it'll tell you some numbers, but it doesn't tell you exactly what's going on. There's so many different factors that could cause a certain performance. Like, for instance, if I went and got neuropsych testing tomorrow, but I couldn't sleep at all tonight, then I'm probably going to perform much worse than if I had a good night's sleep, versus the blood test is the blood test. Now, there's also other things that can impact the blood test for other conditions, but when we're talking about blood-based biomarkers for Alzheimer's disease, right now we're talking about tau proteins and amyloid plaque. So that's pretty much going to be there or it's not. Also, it can help in facilitating clinical trials. So being able to have people who are interested and willing to go through certain trials that are only available to people who have actual Alzheimer's disease or probable Alzheimer's disease, this kind of blood test could make it very much easier to determine, yes, this person fits, no, this person doesn't. And like I said, my favorite reason for a blood-based biomarker is that it can help identify people who truly have something going on that during a 15-minute appointment, it doesn't show up. And so they don't get the attention that they deserve. So it's really going to help that population. Okay, so lots of good reasons, right? Why is this not being used right now? Why right now is it so hard to figure out what's going on if they have dementia, if they don't? Why can't we just start doing this blood test? So currently, there is not a broad consensus onto what specific blood-based biomarker to look for. Right now, we have basically two, tau protein and amyloid plaques that I mentioned before. However, just because somebody has that present doesn't actually mean they're going to develop Alzheimer's disease or that they have it. And when people don't have tau protein or amyloid plaque, it doesn't mean that they don't have Alzheimer's disease. So basically, we're talking about the blood test can run the risk of false positives and false negatives. We know right now that there are people who have evidence of Alzheimer's disease in their brain, that when they die and their brain gets autopsied, there is actual biological evidence that their brain looks like they had Alzheimer's disease, but in their day-to-day life, they had no problems. They were functioning just fine. And then there's evidence of people who, when you look at their brain, they did not have significant tau protein or amyloid plaques, yet they had lots of struggles in their day-to-day life. So it's not like a 100%, you've got this, your blood shows this, then you have it. So that's the main reason this isn't implemented right now, widespread in clinics across the world. The other concern with this type of testing is that if the test results came back positive and showed evidence of possible Alzheimer's disease, it might lead to undertreatment of other conditions like anxiety, depression, poor hearing, underlying infections. We know that Alzheimer's disease and any type of dementia is a dementia of exclusion, meaning we've ruled out any other possible things that it could be. And if somebody had a blood test and it showed, yep, they have this, it looks like they have Alzheimer's disease, it might lead to not really looking to treat all of these other conditions that could really improve the person's thinking. Even if the person still continues to meet diagnosis for Alzheimer's disease, anything we can do to help the other conditions is going to help the person's thinking and overall functioning in their daily life. So what do we think? Will this eventually replace neuropsych testing? This is a question I'm particularly interested in because my husband's a neuropsychologist and he spends all day, every day diagnosing people with dementia or telling them they're fine, figuring out what's going on with their brain. He's the one that's doing the hours and hours of testing. So I don't think this will totally get rid of neuropsych testing because while a blood test might be able to tell us whether or not Alzheimer's disease is likely. What it doesn't tell us is how their brain is functioning. How does this play out in their regular life? Are they having problems with visual memory, verbal memory, processing speed, attention? And what neuropsych testing is really doing, at least good neuropsych testing, it's not just about the diagnosis. This is how their brain is working. And based on these results, this is how you could best interact with your loved one, how you can best communicate with your loved one, and different ways that you can interact. So I don't think there's ever anything that's going to replace that. However, it might be able to better identify the people who would benefit the most from neuropsych testing and maybe save some people who don't really need to go through all that. So BBBs are pretty exciting in the world of Alzheimer's disease. And I do think that we will start seeing it more and more in clinical practice as soon as there's a consensus developed among the medical community on how are we going to interpret these test results, what are we going to do about it, and what specific biomarkers are we looking at. What do you think, Careblazer? Is this an interesting video for you? Were you interested in learning a little bit more about what's on the cutting edge happening in the dementia world? Let me know in the comments below. More importantly, what I am curious about is if this was available, would you go get it? Like right now, would you go get your blood tested for Alzheimer's disease if this was available to you? This brings up lots of questions, like ethical questions, and what would you do to change your lifestyle? I was asking myself this question last night. Would I get the blood test for it? One of my thoughts was, well, what if I just pretended I was positive and then made all the lifestyle changes we already know is important to do now? Let's exercise, stimulate our brain, make sure our hearing is good, make sure, you know, we're stimulating ourselves, all these things that we already know, eating healthy, all the things we already know are super important for dementia prevention. What if we just did that now? That would be really great. But the other thing though is if there were more promising treatments that showed really great results in the early stages, then yeah, I would get it because I would start enrolling in those studies or enrolling in those interventions to help prevent it in the future. So I think my answer personally is yes, I would, but I realize this would cause a lot of anxiety and fear for people. So I'm curious about you. Would you go through with something like this? Let me know. If you haven't already, sign up for your free Dementia Dose newsletter. It's delivered to you every single Thursday to your inbox. There's a link below. You can click and sign up. I'll see you next week. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.